I want to welcome Peter Roseg of Hawaiian Electric. Thank you. I know you have been a regular guest here during the days and during the evenings. And I know that your kuleana is primarily the island of Oahu, but I know that it is one company that oversees the neighbor islands. First of all, in anticipation of any storm,
right,
whether it be you or Maui Electric or Helco on the Big Island, many steps are taken, many procedures are put into place, even well before an event like this, true?
That's right, Howard. We start watching as soon as the Weather Service tells us we've got something to watch. We stood up the emergency management team on Hawaii Island, I think on Sunday. Yesterday we stood up on Maui, and as we speak here on Oahu, the emergency management team is forming over at Ward Avenue, going into 12-hour shifts. Well before that, of course, we're battening down in the substations, and we are making sure that nothing's going to fly away at the power plants, doing whatever checking we can if the vegetation management team's been out for a while. So everything we can do before the storm hits, I think we've done. We've had, unfortunately, some practice getting ready, and we are, I'd like to say we're getting pretty good at it. And now we wait for to see what happens, and we see where in that cone of uncertainty we're going to actually see the storm. It does look like Maui, and to the extent the Big Island, will get the first hit. And we are, they're ready. They have teams in place. They won't go out in the worst of the storm for safety reasons, but as soon as there's some clearing, they'll assess damage. We encourage people to report outages on the neighbor islands by telephone here on Oahu. You can also use our mobile app so that we know where the problems are, and our planners can get ready.
What are the suggestions that you have for residents? I know Maui Electric, they did put out some warnings initially saying, be prepared for the very good possibility of some blackouts during the course of this event. And as the storm continues to shift, that may change, it may get worse in some areas, the concerns may lessen in other areas. But as a resident, what should you do in terms of preparing for a storm? Should you unplug some of your equipment in anticipation of possible outages and storms? Give us your best advice.
Sure. First of all, we recommend that everybody charge up their devices that they have, then unplug. Unplug those chargers. They don't, while there's nothing in them, they're drawing power, but they're not doing you any good. Mm-hmm. Unplug the kind of sensitive equipment that if there were a surge could be hurt. That doesn't mean give up your television, of course. Television, radio, but if you have sensitive equipment, we recommend you unplug that. Recommend you turn your refrigerator and freezer up to the highest level and keep it closed. As long as possible, if there is an outage, your food will stay good for a while, but you don't want to be opening and closing that a lot. If you do leave your home, if you do evacuate, we encourage you to think about turning the power off at the main, or at least turning off everything else that you're going to leave behind, because that reduces the load when we get time to recover. Remember that if you are without power and you use a generator, keep the generator and fuel outside. Don't plug in your entire house into the generator, just the things you're using. If you decide to use candles, please be careful. Yeah. Last thing you need is a fire. Last time we had some fires and we were praying for rain, it doesn't come when you need it. Kahe as well. So, I think everybody, if they've been paying attention at all for the last few months, the basic drill. And here on Oahu, it's not too late to download the Hawaiian Electric mobile app. It gives you a way to report your outage instantly right into our computer system and helps us and helps you.
Talk to us a little bit about some of the inherent dangers for people that wander outside. Anytime you have a down power line, always assume it's live.
Exactly.
But now you have a down power line with the potential of being in an area where it's wet with puddles. Now you got a double whammy.
Right. One thing I learned not too long ago is when you see a down power line, you should stay 30 feet away. I didn't realize that you have, even when the ground is dry, you have the potential of underground electricity moving basically about 3 car lengths.
Wow.
So if you see it, stay away from it. Call the 911 if there's an immediate danger. Call the electric company if it's just lying there on the ground. You cannot know by looking at it whether there's power, whether it's energized, or whether it's not. So beware. Don't try to do a rescue yourself. Don't try to move any of our equipment yourself. It's not worth the risk. And, you know, that's always true whether you're in a storm or otherwise, but especially, as you say, when the ground could be wet, that power has the ability to move a lot further away than I realized until fairly recently.
Interesting. What about driving? You know, people might think, okay, I'm in my car, I have four rubber tires, I'm kind of grounded, I could drive over something.
I highly recommend you not try it. You know, as you said, you're better off sheltering in place. You're better off getting to somewhere where you can shelter well in advance of that, you know, before it gets too dark, before it gets too much into the storm if you're on the neighbor islands. We don't recommend driving over wires again. The ground is fertile for electricity, and you know, the worst thing that could happen is a further accident in that case. So, and pretty soon, with the rain, we're going to see flooding, and that's not a good time to be out in your car as well. So everything says stay home if you can, get to a friend or family if you can, and avoid being on the road. There are also going to be branches and all kinds of stuff, and you don't want to be driving around in that.
Certainly, you could probably speak more about Hawaiian Electric on Oahu than Maui or Helco, Hawaiian Electric Light Company on the Big Island, in terms of upgrades. And there have been a lot of upgrades in recent years, in fact, recent decades, but in the most recent period. Is there a threshold to what you are able to say? I know there's no science or no given number, but you know, where do you start and other utility companies start getting uncomfortable when you start to see winds at a certain 50, 60, 70? What starts to get you guys worried?
Well, most equipment is made to be able to withstand up to about 100 miles per hour. But that doesn't mean that a weaker, you know, a gust, a weaker, you know, weaker problem cannot cause us difficulties. We're more actually concerned about the branches or the fronds that are flying around in the air, touching two of our wires and making a connection that then causes an outage. So, you know, we've spent, as you say, about $1.5 billion among the three companies in the last 6 or 7 years hardening the system. But there is no way to harden it to guarantee that you will not have things flying around, you'll not have an outage. Some piece that looked okay last week breaks in a heavy wind, even a light wind, so to speak. So, you know, we do all we can, and then we hope for the best.
And so people might think, well, all the more reason we need to invest in underground power lines, but then there's a whole other issue because underground power lines can flood.
Exactly right. So there's no guarantees in any of this thing. Underground can flood, and those can be very difficult and time-consuming to repair. In general, overhead is more susceptible to wind, obviously, and if the wind's not blowing, it's a little faster and easier to repair. Underground, not susceptible to wind, but susceptible to flooding, and it's a lot more difficult and, frankly, dangerous when you have a lot of water in these person holes, I think we're supposed to call them, in these vaults and so forth. So there is no right or wrong. It's what's best in the area, and what, you know, in some areas you have to underground, in some areas it makes more sense.
And finally, you said you are staging in preparation. I know, for example, Manny Nevis, the Honolulu fire chief, said they're putting incident management teams in place, in position on different parts of the islands. Same with the city's facility management, facility maintenance teams. Is that similar to what HECO's doing? You said you're staging 12-hour shifts. Are you going and being set up in the places that you know history tells you are the most vulnerable?
Well, first of all, we're working very closely with all the responders you talked about. We have representatives down at what used to be called civil defense at the Haima. You know, so we're able to talk to them and they to us. So we work very closely with the police and fire and all the folks that would be responding. We tend to stage in our own plants, in our own yards, in our own facilities because we know we're safer there. And then, as I said, we get the information from people about outages. Our system shows outages, and we figure out where we need to roll after it's clear to roll. But in a storm like this, we will, you know, we won't roll if it's dangerous, but it could be just heavy winds and rains, and we can still roll out teams, roll out crews. So that's why we encourage people to report the outage as soon as possible. Don't assume that we're going to be hunkering down. If we can get out to you before the worst hits or even, you know, through a bad rainstorm, our folks are incredible. They climb up poles in the rain. They handle electricity with, you know, gloved hands, and we will make every effort to get to you as soon as we possibly can. So that's why the reporting is really valuable for you and valuable for us.
I will work on plumbing. I will work on carpentry at home. I don't like working with electricity. It's a whole other animal that one should leave to the experts, right?
I'll say that because I'm not the expert at all. I wouldn't touch it either, but we have great crews.
All right. Well, appreciate it. It's kind of like an umpire in a baseball game. It's always best if you don't see him or hear from him or even notice him. So we always appreciate you coming, but I hope we don't have to see you for another week or two.
I'd live without seeing you too. But I think everybody really appreciates the information and the assurance that things are being prepared, that things are getting ready. And we're grateful to you and one or two other stations, which I wouldn't name, that you guys are really...
We do know that there's at least one other out there, I think.
But you guys are terrific in terms of giving people the reassurance that, you know, that we just like to hear that things are getting ready and things are going to be handled, and we owe you a lot for that.
It goes two ways. Thank you very much. Peter Osek with Hawaiian Electric Company. Thank you very much. Be safe. Have a nice, quiet night.
I hope so. You too.